And here's Lee Brown, who is the almost the brunt of it all. And Lee takes it down in shorthand, and we sit and talk about it afterwards, and she types it up for me, and then we edit it. And I use Lee as a kind of a, I suppose you might say, a litmus paper. I use her as a kind of an audience, and I can always tell she has a just peculiar way. Whenever I'm not writing well, she looks like she's made out of silly putty. And then I know that I better start all over again. Lee, I'd like to ask you a question, something that I've never really asked you.
Maybe better not.
At 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock in the morning, and I'm telling you a story, we're writing something for Playboy or for a novel, do you find yourself waiting to hear what's going to happen next?
Sure. Oh, of course, because you have a way of kind of leading people along, and every sentence leads to another sentence, and you never really tip your hand, so I really have no way of knowing what's going to happen next. Most writers are very predictable, and you know doggone well that if Charlie is... The last scene, you see Charlie walking across the street on his way to get married to this fantastic girl. You know he's going to get hit by a car, and he's going to get killed. But you never do that. And, it disappoints me terribly when you get tired and say, well, all right, I'll finish it tomorrow, because I want to know what happened.
Well, that's, I guess, the greatest compliment a writer can have, is to have the people who work with them sit there and wait for the next line to find out what's going to happen. And personally, I don't know what's going to happen next. I'm working on another novel. I love writing. And I think that any of you who've got the slightest urge to write, you better do it. It's the greatest thing in the world.